Hello and welcome to this video about upgrading products using Command Central stacks. Command Central 10.7 introduces functionality for upgrading software GUI products using software stacks. You can now upgrade your environment from a central place. The advantages of using stacks for products upgrade are: the upgrade of all software GUI installations is done in parallel, reducing the downtime of the upgraded environment. The task is done using a single product, Command Central, which internally orchestrates all required tools like Software Engine Store, Update Manager, and Product Migration Utilities. The upgrade can be done using a few clicks in the Command Central web UI, or it can be fully automated using the Command Central command line tool. You can perform upgrade on standard product installations even if you don't know how to develop templates. So why do we need stacks? A stack is a set of product runtimes and related database components. A stack can perform bulk operations on the included components. One of the bulk operations is precisely the upgrade. For overview of the Command Central software stacks, please see the related video in our channel. Before performing upgrade using stacks, check the relevant documentation, including the Software AG Command Central supported features metrics for the supported product configuration and migration types. Also, follow the instructions in upgrading Software AG products to prepare the existing installations for the upgrade. In addition, perform the following steps in Command Central. Set up a product repository with the release version you are upgrading to. Also, set up a fixed repository that will be used to install the applicable fixes for the new products. By default, Command Central installs all applicable fixes available in the selected repository. Before upgrading, you should also have the Command Central Bootstrap installed for the new release. The Bootstrapper will be used for installing and upgrading of the Platform Manager instances. Another prerequisite is to import valid license keys for the Software AG products in your stacks. If the Platform Manager instances have non-default passwords, then register Platform Manager credentials. Finally, if you are upgrading on remote machines, register the required SSH connection credentials to access the machines. In this video, we are going to look at three cases that show how to upgrade Software AG products on multiple installations using stacks in Command Central. Depending on the directory and hosts that you want to have after the upgrade, Command Central provides three upgrade types. The first option is overinstall upgrade. The upgrade will be performed on the same hosts and in the same installation directory. The second option is side-by-side upgrade. Again, the upgrade will be executed on the same hosts, but this time in different installation directory. The last option is cross-host upgrade, where the operation will be performed on different hosts and the installation directory can be the same or different. So let's see how this functionality works in Command Central. In my demo environment, I have Command Central 10.7 installation, which has the following 10.7 product repository and also a fixed repository. All license keys for the products included in the demo are imported in Command Central. The SSH connectivity credentials for the remote machines are registered too. This Command Central manages two integration server instances connected to a Microsoft SQL Server database and also two universal messaging instances. The release version of the instances is 10.5 and they are installed on two nodes under the home VMtest SAG installation directory. The instances in the demo environment are composed in a stack named MyStack with version 10.5. The infrastructure layer contains the Platform Manager instances on the remote nodes. The database layer represents the Microsoft SQL Server database used by Integration Server. The messaging layer contains the two universal messaging instances, and the integration layer contains the two Integration Server instances. As Software AG strongly recommends using cloned database when testing an upgrade, the first task I'll do is to add the already cloned production database in the stack. To do that, I'll first delete the production database layer. Now, I'll add the clone database as an existing database layer. The database component configurator is installed only in one of the nodes, so I'll select that node. Finally, I'll enter the clone database connection details, including the database name, database connection URL, database type, database username, and database password. The clone database layer is created in the stack and we are ready to execute the upgrade. Let's upgrade to release 10.7 on the same host but in a different installation directory. This means I should select the side-by-side upgrade option. In the first step, I'll choose the Bootstrap installer for the new release, the product repository for the new release, and the fix repository. Note that I have already placed the Bootstrap installer in the Command Central installation under Profiles CC Data Installers directory. In the next step, I'll enter the parameters required for upgrading each layer, starting from the infrastructure layer. Some parameters have default values that were taken from the source installation, while others require my input. I have to specify the new installation directory, select SSH credentials, and Platform Manager credentials. My demo Platform Manager instances have default credentials, so I'm selecting default administrator. I want all applicable fixes to be installed. The default SSH port matches the SSH port of my remote machines. I'll use the default settings for the database layer upgrade and move to the messaging layer parameters. The only required parameter here is the universal messaging license key. I should also select a license key for the integration server instances in the integration layer. As I have cloned the production database before the upgrade, I have to change the integration server instances database URL so that it points to the clone database after the upgrade. Now, I can export the parameter values in a file, which I can reuse in the UI or in automation scenario, perform a dry run of the upgrade, or upgrade the stack. The dry run option and upgrade templates modifications are covered in one of our next videos, so for this demo, I'll just perform the upgrade. The upgrade stack job has started and I can monitor the progress. There are three high-level stages performed for each runtime in the stack. The first one is exporting composite templates, the second one is validating the exported templates, and the final task is executing the templates in migration mode. This means that before the migration process begins, Command Central will validate that the product scheduled for upgrade and the specified fixes are available in the selected repositories for the new release. The SSH connectivity to the remote machines and availability of the license keys is also validated. While the upgrade job is running, I can check the set of generated composite templates for upgrading. The job completed successfully and I can verify that the stack is upgraded. The stack release version is now 10.7. All instances in the stack can be started and there is connectivity to the migrated clone database. The nodes version is 10.7 and the installation directory is now home vmtest sag new. I can also navigate to the integration server web UI and check the release version. For performing an upgrade of type overinstall, I have to follow the same steps, but as the installation directory is the same, the upgrade wizard will not ask me to provide an installation directory. The cross-host upgrade type also has the same flow as the side-by-side upgrade type. But as new hosts will be used, the wizard will ask me to provide a new host name for each installation and an option to select different SSH connectivity credentials for the source and target machines. The stack upgrade task can be performed and automated using the following CLI commands. For details, please check the Command Central documentation. This concludes our demo. Thank you for watching.